like you. You seem like a very, very intelligent man.
You're doing this just to kill a cow. You can do whatever you want to do.
So obviously you're smarter than me. What the hell does that mean? Or is that right?
Albert Einstein's IQ was 164.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of the Above Average Baseball Show podcast. Today, we're talking the trade deadline, what to expect and everything. But first, subscribe to the channel, like the videos, watch them all through. Helps everybody out. I'm dead serious. The new YouTube metrics, it doesn't help my channel out. It helps every channel out. Trust me. So, more than ever, I'm going to be keeping a hawk's eye on my phone and everything as we're this close to the trade deadline as well. So, first, let's start with Justin Verlander. What is going to happen with him? I don't see him traded, just as Mark Feinsand said today on his chatting practice thing he did with some fans earlier today. I just don't see it. They traded Scherzer, got a good prospect. Ronald Acuna's little brother, by the way. And I just don't think the Mets will trade Verlander. I don't think any team is going to come close to the price tag. Okay? So what is going on with the seller's market? It is crazy seller's market. I have never seen a seller's market like this before. It's nuts. Nuts. Closest one I can remember, I think, was back when the Yankees got Rizzo. About 2 years ago, almost exactly, I believe it is now. And, yeah, it is quite interesting to see. I don't think the Angels make the playoffs, even with their moves. Rangers, I think, will hold on to the division. I think Scherzer gets them there once he's actually pitching for them. I think the Rangers will get hot again. I think the Yankees are going to get hot. We know the Yankees are going to have that hot streak. That's a guarantee. Exactly. What do they do at the trade deadline? Well, Pisano and Rosenthal, Eric Kratz, Feinstein have all said recently, even Joel Sherman, they are working on things. They are going to make moves. They're going to trade guys away as well as add guys. To quote Joel Sherman, it's a guarantee they trade a few guys away to save salary while adding some players. Some they are after, mind you. Yaimer Candelario of the Nationals is a big target for them, okay? Another one is Ryan McMahon of the Rockies and Nolan Jones of the Rockies. They're in talks with both teams. We'll see what happens. There's also always that Cashman surprise move, but bear in mind, the Yankees are only looking for left-handed bats. Cashman wants to add balance and such into this lineup, okay? They're only looking for those left-handed bats. Left-handed. It's his hand. Keep that in mind. Also, Dylan Carlson. There's high probability they go get him, and the Cardinals are still struggling at shortstop, so it could be like a one-for-one swap, say Peraza for Carlson. That is still possible. If that happens, Bader is gone. Yes, Bader is on the trade block right now. I can tell you that one. He's likely gone. Long gone. The Cubs, what are they going to do? Likely they're going to add and sell. And if they sell, it's going to be a high contract they think they can get rid of on the cheap, which they don't have a lot of. So it might be they just add, as Mark Feinstein said. There's a chance they can stand pat, just roll with what they have. And they are a favorite for a wild card, okay? They are a favorite for a wild card. Keep that in mind. What else could they do from here? The Cubs could really use another starter and some back-end help. There's not a lot in either market. The big bullpen arms just aren't available this year. There's not a lot of good starters. There's Jack Flaherty, Eduardo Rodriguez, Lorenzen of the Tigers as well, and maybe Dylan Cease, you could talk the White Sox into trading him. Might be about it, which is not good. Now, the Yankees do have Luis Severino and Domingo Herman on the market. Does anybody really want to take a shot at them? Seriously? I don't think so. We'll see. What else is going on right now? It's not the right button. Oops. There we are. There's a lot of talk, but there's not a lot of moves today. It's a little weird. It's very silent in the trade market. Jack Flaherty is another one that's out there, by the way. Should be an easy get. Expiring contract. Keep that in mind. Get rid of that. I'm looking to see if there's anything new from baseball reporters or my sources. I'm just not hearing things right now. It's weird. I did hear to expect the White Sox to make another trade. It could be anything, by the way. It could be anything. I do not see Dylan Cease or Luis Robert moving. There's a chance they could trade Eloys Jiménez. There's a chance they could trade Yasmani Grandal, but it's not going to be another blockbuster like they've already done three of, okay? I do think they'll make another trade and then call it probably a day. For the Rangers, they are looking for relievers. We'll see what they do. They called up the Yankees, did not get anywhere. Didn't get anywhere trying for Hader, did not get anywhere trying for Bednar. I don't see any of those really moving. If you're going to trade with the Yankees, you're going to have to really pay through the nose, I'm telling you. They have to really pay through the nose. I put up an article earlier today in which I talked about how I would fix the Yankees, and it's already been retweeted by two big-time reporters and has been seen by the Yankees' official Twitter page. I checked the metrics. And by the way, there's a new thing with Twitter, or X, whatever they call a thing. They can hide a retweet or a quote tweet where you cannot actually check who did it. I learned that when I retweeted a girl's post yesterday. Went back to check. Clicked on her post, checked retweets. It didn't show anything. When I knew it was on mine, but checked, it was on mine. So I checked it. Yes, that is a metric now. I don't like it, but it's there. Anyways, things are going to start heating up. We are about 24 hours, 20 minutes from the trade deadline. To give you an exact time, it has changed three times. 2023. This says August 1st, but it's not giving the time. It says 6 p.m., so they moved it back again. We're now 25 hours, 20 minutes away. So 6 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. my time. So actually, we're about 27 hours with that one. They really moved that back. So we're getting close. This is when the Yankees should start moving. Other teams should start moving. They haven't yet. And really start getting aggressive, okay? Keeping an eye on things, no messages. One thing I was told early on is the Yankees are going to make moves, but they're going to be surprising. A couple of them will be surprising. Now, with Nolan Jones and Ryan McMahon, would be surprising, very surprising. Another one, trading Bader away, trading Torres away, trading IKF away. Trading those three away alone would save about $28 million. Yeah. That includes the luxury tax penalties in that. It was just a contract, about $22 million. Torres is making $9.5 million this year and is going to be demanding over $12 million for 2024. Bader is making about $9 million. $6 to $9 million, somewhere in there. And it's at least $6 million for IKF. So it's over $20 million they could save by dropping those three. Keep that in mind. They could save another $1.5 million to $2.5 million if they got rid of Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. He's going to be a free agent in 2 months. He's gone. You're seeing the last of Isaiah Kiner, or excuse me, Kyle Gashioka. He's gone. IKF is a free agent as well in a couple of months. Could they trade Herman? It would save about $6 million. If they trade Severino, it would save about $15 million. Yeah, there's an option for him this offseason for $15 million. I don't know if the Yankees accept it or not at this point. I would reject it. There's no buyout on it. Just a straight-up option. At least when I checked on MLB trade rumors, and the other website, was it called SpotTrack, they both showed no buyout. Another one, this from Ken Rosenthal. He retweeted this, and he said this himself. Teams pay no attention to that trade values website at all. No attention. They ignore it completely. Completely. Okay? Not paying any attention. It's just completely ignored. Guess as good as mine is why. That's serious. But I do know the teams have their own values. One team can value, say, Jason Dominguez as a top prospect in baseball. The other doesn't even seem top 100, which is brain dead. He's clearly a top 10 prospect in baseball. Clearly, it's day 10th at worst. And I think he is the best prospect in baseball, batting .398 in July. Well, he has to have one hit today, and it would be a .400 July for him. Ridiculous what he's done this month. And he will be moving to AAA very soon. He's a AA, if you didn't know that. As will another prospect, what's his name? Oh, Osmond's already moved, that's right. And Spencer Jones expected to move up to AA very soon. And Trey Sweeney as well, either AA or AAA. So there's guys getting close. They're going to be impact bats for the Yankees. Stars? Well, Jones and Dominguez will. Sweeney will probably be that classic 25-30 homer year guy. So when a team does their evaluation, they look at these things. Okay? They look up how fast they move to the system, how they play at current level. That's why I said all that. With Jason Dominguez, some teams think he's batting too low at 235. They're looking at the whole picture. He had a 400 July. He finally adjusted. I'm not sure what he adjusted, but he finally adjusted. His swing looks identical to me. Maybe he finally started looking at those low pitches going, not swinging at him. Or an outside pitch or a high pitch. Something like that. Maybe. So, biggest surprise I could see coming, I would have to say Ryan McMahon and Nolan Jones to the Yankees would be it if it happens. I don't see Verlander trading. Just my intent doesn't see it. The market doesn't see him traded, moving. I could see the Dodgers getting a starter, but it's not going to be a surprise. I could see Bader traded. I could. Wouldn't surprise me at all. Yeah, we'll see. I think there's going to be a bigger player traded. Nobody's expecting out of me. Nobody can foresee it coming. Roland Thapelson wouldn't even have seen this one coming. It could involve the Yankees. It could involve the Cubs. It could involve anybody. Who would that be? I don't know. I know the Padres are still thinking about what to do with Hader and Snell because they're not extending him. And the Yankees are the favorite for both of free agency. Whether they sign him or not, it's a different story. I'd love the Yankees to sign both. It would really beef up that pitching staff. I don't know if they will. Nobody does. Another one is teams are looking at the international market coming up. I mean, you could have five big-time international free agents from Japan alone in the market. Jung-Hoo Lee, that lefty outfielder with smooth swing. Roki Sasaki. Yamamoto. There's another pitcher. I cannot remember his name. And also, there is an outside chance Minutaka Murakami could get posted. He's going to apply for it again and see if his team will. If he will, he's going to the Yankees. And he will be the first baseman for the Yankees in 2024 if he gets posted. I don't think he will. But that's this deadline expected to start heating up now. We're getting close. Just over 24 hours away. I think it's 27 hours away right now. We're getting into the crunch time. Gotta keep alert now. Gotta keep alert now. Do you expect a lot of trades to start popping out now? Probably 25 between now and tomorrow's deadline. And a lot will be minor, prospect for prospect or one player for prospect type thing. I think the biggest trade was Scherzer, for being honest. A one-for-one was a little surprising, but that's what the big contract does. Keep that in mind. Big contracts lower it. Some people are asking, with J.D. Martinez on the IL, would Stanton get traded? Dodgers have no interest right now. In the offseason, that could change, depending on if they get Shohei Ohtani or not. Okay? And Ohtani's gone. I'm told, again, keep an eye on the Dodgers. The Dodgers team is going to grab him. They're going to make a big offer, try to close that one quickly. So we'll see once that happens. That's expectation. But again, close out by saying, I don't expect Verlander to move. Yankees are going to make moves. A lot of teams are going to make moves now. Stay alert. Have a great day, everybody. Remember, the King Source loves you.